So tell me, when you took the practice classic aptitude test, did you know the answer? Did you guess? You and I give it to me, some fans, an actor, urban, the jacket, the sound scan. With some math, you'd my mom so laughably, Zachary shaking your time vocabulary. Styles like garbage cans, meant to be taken out on a weekly basis. Ever since your first break, you've been in a state of suspended animation. You look like Snuffleupagus, Nostropithecus, me quick, you epicus. Enough about you, let's talk about me, and I'll single handedly read the fine signs of ray astronomy. Making up a prize when it's questioning notions of reality. Oh, but I digress, you ain't sorry, I always win in chess. Don't get some quicker sets. Clever with that mic when it's here. Do you really think it's that easy? This is really good ice cream. You want some of it? Oh my bad, I didn't know you were lactose intolerant. Makes you pass gas frights all the goes away. All the friends you keep with those you pay. Always waiting for the wax snack. Decade sandwich rather. Straight in style, change more backpack. Got the gadget to get bombed. Enjoy your mind, make you jump the pod. You quack, quack, grab your arms and use, but completely unharmed. Years have been rather intense. I'm ashamed to admit that I'm a fool by seductions of violence. People walk around with ugly oars, sometimes even tempted to seek the advice of Dr. Laura. But I know I'll take a deep breath and count to ten. And I'm a lead again under my skin. Take a deep breath and count to ten. Think of all the nice places that I've been. Back when I was raging against the mythos, I was through the ancient mysteries by a wiser philosopher. From the polyrhythm of celestial time, make the world count to get it done. I've been a spell.
In the making in the Daily Beat, because we're going to write a song today. Everyone in the audience, because there's lots of Clutch fans here, obviously. You guys have filled this place. So. Now, our whacked out brains of the Daily Beat have figured something out. We got Perry, your new album's in stores today, Solo Records, out today. We're going to get Perry to write a song title and the first line of a song, and then we're going to have everyone in the audience, you're going to get a chance to fill in the song with your own line, okay? And then at the end of the show, Clutch is going to play that song.
Yeah.
All right. All right, check it out. Welcome back to the Daily Beat. We're talking to friends of Clutch in the audience here. So who would you never go see in concert?
I don't know. Michael Bolton.
That's a good choice.
Yeah.
Yeah. Does he still have the mullet happening? I haven't
I'm not a fan on. Why would you ask me?
Okay, sorry. I thought you were keeping track. What about you, man?
I'd have to go with Bon Jovi. Too much of a pansy for me.
Okay. All right. You're not into Bad Medicine and
no.
Yeah, what was the one line, when you get drunk, I'll be the wine?
Yeah.
Okay, sorry.
No Better Roses.
Any of you guys in Clutch? Dan, you got an opinion on this?
We're talking about it, and personally, Elton John, myself.
Really? You wouldn't want to hear the old Rocket Man, any of those favorites?
No. Aww. Not feeling it.
Okay. All right. Rachel, chilling out with Perry here. What's up?
Yeah, we're working on the song.
I have a title.
You have a title?
Yeah.
What's the title?
Should I say it out loud?
Yeah, let's hear it right now.
Yeah, show it to us.
My friends call me Bullseye. That's gonna be going.
All right. Great title. My friends call me Bullseye. So make sure everybody now, you're thinking about a line for the song. No profanity. Don't screw it up. Okay? All right. I'm here with Clutch. Now, a couple things I want to ask you about. First off, I heard a strange thing that you guys built this contraption when you're touring in your van, because obviously when you tour, space is cramped. You know, you're trying to find places to sleep. So what did you guys rig up in your van?
This is quite some time ago. This is our first van. It was called the Thunder Chief.
Okay.
And we had a swinging platform on chains, right? And we put all the gear underneath there. But see, the platform swung back and forth when there wasn't enough gear in there. And I guess we just, in our naivete, just decided that we would put our heads directly in line with the windshield. So when anytime you step on the brakes, 9 times out of 10, you ended up in between the front, you know, two seats. So that was a learning experience.
It would break down to who's driving, if it was on purpose or not, right?
Yeah. We actually sold the Thunder Chief for the cost of the tow truck driver wrecker that got it off our hands.
Okay.
$200.
Very nice.
God rest its soul.
Now, you guys live all in West Virginia now, right? What is it about West Virginia? I don't meet too many people. Usually people, you know, leave West Virginia and come somewhere, you know. What is it about West Virginia that you guys like so much?
How cheap it is. It's really cheap to live out there.
Okay, well, like,
we're from the D.C. area, where if you wanted to rent a house like we have in the D.C. area right on the Potomac, it'd probably be at least a couple grand a month, where we get ours for $750.
What's ours? Like, where are you living now, right?
We live
now?
In Shepherdstown, West Virginia.
Yeah, but what
70
kind of,
miles
what
northwest
kind of pad are we talking about?
It's like a...
It's a ranch house?
Basically. It's like a retirement home that some guy moved out of, basically.
It's big, though.
No.
No?
Super small.
Oh, okay. Now, you guys toured with Marilyn Manson, and I heard in the beginning that you were kind of apprehensive because, you know, when Hole, I saw the Hole Marilyn Manson show, the audience wasn't very receptive to Hole. You know, you get all these goth kids in there, and they're not...
I went into that tour with a real bad attitude, I'll admit that. And you know what, it was 4 months long, and after the 4 months I realized it was really a wise decision because, you know, the front rows of any crowd, when you're opening up for somebody, those are always the most passionate fans.
Yeah.
And, you know, after the third month of, you know, the 13-year-old kid dressed up like a vampire looking at me like I'm the jerk, you know, it got really, really old.
Yeah.
But then, you know, those kids came to go see us later on.
Okay.
And they were, and at the band were gentlemen, and... you know, I'm glad we did it in retrospect.
Right on. So you did pick up some fans from that.
Yeah.
Okay. You had Delfeo Marcellus, which is the younger brother of Wynton and Branford. He played trombone on your last record.
Yes.
How did you hook up with this guy? Was he a fan, or did you approach him? How did it come together?
We saw him playing with Elvin Jones.
Down in D.C. at the Blues Alley Club. We went to see Elvin Jones, jazz drummer, and he had Delfeo play in his band, and that was the first time we were exposed to him.
Yeah.
And
we showed up to the house in a white trench coat in the mud. I'll never forget that. He almost looked like he was going to turn away. It was night and it was storming, and he had a white trench coat on with his trombone, standing in the rain, looking like he was just about to hightail it out of there. I said, no, you got the right place. And this white felt trench coat covered in mud.
You guys have been around now for a long, I mean, this is your 7th release. We talked about this earlier, I mean, with 4 LPs, 3 EPs. I'm always curious when I talk to bands who have been around for so long, what your take is on the music today, now, what's going on?
It's the same as it ever was, I think. In the big picture, things happen cyclically. There's always a reaction, and then it becomes extreme, and then it becomes a parody of itself, and then there's a reaction against that. Nowadays, I think there's a lot of melodrama. Lyrically, you know, a lot of kind of whining about problems that really aren't problems in the big picture of life. And, you know, but each their own. There's obviously, you know, it speaks to people, and that, you know, I'm not That's just not our bag.
Okay. Well, that's important to note because we are going to be passing around the song lyrics, the song you're going to sing. No whining, okay, from everybody here. Okay.
Nothing about ex-girlfriends or how lonely you are.
Okay, that's important. And then also, what I have here, check this out. Because I have heard that you are quite the vocabularian. That's sort of a Don King word, right? Okay? So I've got this dictionary here, you know, if you want to use it for when we're writing the songs, you know, lyrics and stuff, because you tend to have some words in there that people may go, hmm.
Oh, okay. I've read this.
You what? you wrote this?
Yeah. No. I'm just kidding.
Hey, so remember the song. I'm super happy that you guys have decided to play this song. So, hey, Perry, do we got the first line of the song? What's going on?
Yeah, we do. Yeah.
What's the first line? Can we hear it?
My friends call me Bullseye.
Well, that's the title, right?
Okay. Oh. Okay.
Yeah, what?
How did it go?
Can we have the mic?
That'll be it,
Perry. Bullseye's my name because I got great aim. We're taking care of you guys. Yeah. It's gonna go smooth.
This is gonna be a big hit. Do I get like part of the mechanical or the royalties on this song if this happens? Half a point? Mm-hmm. All right, that's on tape, dude. Okay, when we get back, we'll talk more with Perry Farrell, we'll talk with Clutch, we'll continue the Daily Beats first ever song that we're writing all together as one. Everybody kind of think about what you're going to write when the pad gets to you.
Now listen, in the studio we have Perry Farrell, the guys from Clutch, writing a song. And the title of the song, John, what's the title of that song again? Zeke, what's the title of the song?
It is...
What's the name of the chick
with
the long hair?
My friends
call me Bullseye. Do you have a line for the song that maybe we can incorporate it? My friends call me Bullseye.
About my friends call me Bullseye. Why? Because...
I
his
like
feet are made of kosher meat.
Oh, right. My friends call me Bullseye.
His feet are made of kosher meat.
Why?
We got it. Stephon Tell.
We are done here, brother. So back in the studio. Rock out.
All right, cool.
Why?
Because my feet are made of kosher meat. It makes sense.
It,
totally. Thanks, Stephon.
No problem.
Cool. Now performing this song from Pure Rock Fury. It's the new album out from Clutch.
Who asked the questions that happened? immortal.
Yeah!
Thank you.
Yeah! Nice, bro. All right. We'll get back results of Live and Let Die video about history in the making, though. The very first song ever composed on the Daily Beat. Perry Farrell started it. Your fans finished it.
We'll ruin it.
That's after the break. It's the Daily Beat. Cool. Okay, now it is. Here it is right now. You've been waiting. It's history in the making. The first song ever composed on the Daily Beat. Perry Farrell gave it the title, My Friends Call Me Bullseye. And right now, Clutch is going to play it. Here we go.
Excellent.
Empty out the keg, a thirsty drunk on his last leg. My chances of counting is nebulous. 30,000 newspapers in the backseat. I'm a paper for an apparition, and I'm gonna smoke, smoke, smoke till I broke, broke, broke. Lots of wind while thoroughbreds, while shooting snake bite on us in the sun, down in the bomb shelter of Kingdom Begun. Why, cause his feet are always made of kosher meat. Slice me, walk without a razor blade, one way, rock away beats. I stuff my pants with the socks, so the girls all come in to run and flock. I come in like a hurricane and leave you wanting more. Take the pills from behind me in the stash of Arctic Core. Yeah, I got a station wagon, so get off my chunk. Back it. But there is spilled out my smut. Monstrosity of robust verbosity fills me with viscosity. These ramblings make me want to have a histomosity. Histomosity. I took your mama to the Bahamas. That's right.
Metro TV knows New York fashion and fun. Tonight at 8 on Full Frontal Fashion Weekly, Andre Leon Talley has advice for getting you men in line with fashion. Then we go shopping with Nan Kemper. At 8:30, comedian Susie Essman gives out sage advice on love and dating in the Big Apple and Subway Q&A. Turn on New York wisdom. Metro TV. Turn on New York.